Welcome back, student. Today we are going to study element. Let's have brainstorming upon element. Element. Students, we all know that the smallest particle of a substance is molecule. The smallest particle of substance is molecule. And the substance whose molecule is made up of one or more atoms. Molecule made up of one or more atoms which are exactly alike, same, is called as element. This is the definition which is given in our textbook. One more time. Let's have brainstorming upon element. The smallest particle of substance is molecule, and the substance whose molecule is made up of one or more atoms which are exactly alike is called as element. In simple terms, we can say that a substance which is made up of only one type of atom is called as element. The substance which is made up of same kind of atom is called as element. Example. We take example of gold and silver. if we take 2 sheets of metals, one gold, another silver, and break it into pieces. My dear student, the smallest particle of a substance is molecule, and the substance whose molecule is made up of atoms which are exactly alike is called as element. Example, gold and silver. If we take two thin sheets of gold and silver. For example, if we take a gold sheet and break down it into pieces, then the smallest piece which we will get is molecule of gold. The molecule of gold can also be broken into small pieces, then we will get atom of gold. Atom is the smallest particle of a substance which cannot be broken into pieces. Atom is indivisible. And if we get an atom which are of same kind, then such substance is called as element. One more time. If we take gold, make small small pieces of gold, we will get molecule of gold. If we break a molecule of gold, we will get atom of gold. And if all the atoms of gold are of same kind, then gold is called as element. In the same way, if we take a thin sheet of silver and break it into pieces, we will get molecule of silver. If we break the molecule of silver, then we will get atom of silver. And if all the atoms of silver are of same kind, are exactly alike, then this substance whose atoms are of same kind will be called as element. My dear student, there are 118 elements found, out of which 92 are found in nature. The remainings are man-made. In our book, some elements are given. These elements are given in increasing order of their atomic number. We all have to learn these elements because
these elements are very very important for us because they will be useful for us in 8th standard, 9th standard and 10th standard also. So let's consider some example of elements which are given in our book.
My dear student, there are 20 elements given in our textbook. These elements are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic number. The sequence which is given in our book is important. So, you have to write it in a sequence and also learn it in sequence. The element is represented by a name. And it is represented by the first letter of its name. Sometimes the first letter is same. Therefore, the first and the second letter of the name of the element is used to represent an element. For example, H stands for hydrogen. The second element is helium. H is common, so He, the small letter E, the next letter is used as the symbol for representing elements. The elements which are given in our book are hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium and calcium, and they are represented by the first letter of its name. One more time, we'll consider the elements which are given in our book. Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium and calcium. Let's have brainstorming upon classification of elements. Classification of elements. My dear student, elements are classified into three types depending upon their properties. They are metals, metalloids, and non-metals. Let's have brainstorming upon metals. The substance which have the following property, such as malleability, ductility, conductivity of heat and electricity, density, luxure, sorority, are called as metals. The substances which show the property such as malleability, ductility, conductivity of heat and electricity, density, luxure, sorority are called as metals. Whereas the substance which do not show the following properties such as malleability, ductility, conductivity of heat and electricity, density, luxure, sorority are called as non-metals. The non-metals are the substance which do not have the properties such as malleability, ductility, conductivity of heat and electricity, density, luxure, sorority are called as non-metals. Whereas metalloids are the substance which has the properties of both metals and non-metals. Therefore, the substance which have properties of both metals and non-metals are called as metalloids. That's all, student. We'll stop here.